Hello students, welcome to AJ Akshara Academy YouTube channel. In this session, I am going to discuss refraction of light lecture 1. This video no mother sir chuse varu daichesi like cheyandi, share cheyandi, subscribe cheyandi. Mee yokka amoolyamaina abhiprayalanu tappaka maa comment section lo telicheyandi. Okay, let us go to the today's topic, refraction of light lecture 1. Refraction of light. Light travels in a straight line. This is true as long as in the same medium having the same density throughout. See the picture. So this is the picture. One boy is observing the light rays whenever the light rays are incidenting, and here this is the interface, and the light rays are after traveling one medium to another medium. Here it is slightly, it is bending, so it is changing the directions. Next one. If however the light rays are made to go from one transparent medium to another transparent medium, light rays change their direction or bend at the boundary separating two media. Here is the two medias are there. One is air media and it is a denser medium, that is water. Here we are taking here a pond and it is filled with water, and we are observing the light rays are incidenting from one medium to another medium. So whenever the light rays are made to go from one transparent medium to another transparent medium, here the light rays are coming from rarer to denser medium. At an interface, the light rays are changing their directions, nothing but they bent at the boundary separating two media. This is we are calling as the interface. Interface nothing but a line which separates two medias. So whenever the light rays are traveling from one medium to another medium, light rays change their direction or bent at the boundary separating two media. Next, for example, when light rays traveling in air to go into another medium, say glass. Here two medias are, one is air medium, other is a glass. They change the direction or bent or entering the glass medium. The bending of light ray when it travels from one medium to another medium is called a refraction of light. Here this changing phenomena, whenever the light rays are traveling from one medium to another medium, it changes the direction. So the bending rays of light whenever it travels from one medium to another medium, it changes the direction. This phenomena is known as refraction of light. So bending of light ray, the bending of light ray or ray of light when it travels from one medium to another is called refraction. Here this is the air medium and this is we are now calling as a denser medium. Now the light rays are coming from rarer to denser. This is an interface, nothing but a line which separates two media. Here it is looking like a little bit bending. This bending beam of light or bending ray of light here looking like it is bending. Bending of a ray of light when it travels from one medium to another medium. Here the light ray coming from air medium to water medium, that is rarer to, here we are calling as a rarer medium, rarer to denser. One medium it is air, here another medium it is here water. Or we can say, suppose for example glass, they change the direction. So this changing the direction is known as refraction of light, the bending of ray of light when it travels from one medium to another is called refraction of लाइट. नेक्स्ट, ऑप्टिकली रेयर मीडियम एंड ऑप्टिकली डेंसर मीडियम. नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग व्हाट इज मेंट बाय ऑप्टिकली रेयर मीडियम एंड ऑप्टिकली डेंसर मीडियम. फर्स्ट वन, ए ट्रांसपेरेंट सब्सटेंस इन विच लाइट रेस इज नोन एज ए मीडियम. एयर, ग्लास, वाटर, अल्कोहल एक्सेट्रा आर ऑल द एग्जाम्पल्स of different media. Different medias are said to have different optical densities. So now what is meant by optically rarer medium? Nothing but a transparent substance in which light travels is known as a medium. Medium nothing but a substance in which light rays travels is known as a medium. Here, for example, here we are taking air is a medium and glass, water, alcohol, etc. are all the examples of different media. Different media are said to have different optical densities. So, different medias have different optical densities. Okay, next. Now, the speed of light depends on the optical density of medium. Therefore, the light travels with different speeds in different media having different optical densities. So, for example, the speed of light in air is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second, whereas that in glass is 2 × 10⁸ meter per second, and in water it is 2.25 × 10⁸ meters per second. So, whenever the light travels from one medium to another medium, it changes its direction based on the speed of light. So, here, for example, the light ray traveling from air medium to glass. So, what the speed of light in air is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second, and in glass 2 × 10⁸ meters per second, and in water 2.25 × 10⁸ meters per second. So light travels with different speeds in different medias having different optical densities. So for example, speed of light is different for all the medias. Example, air 3 × 10⁸, glass 2 × 10⁸ meter per second, and in water 2.25 × 10⁸ meters per second. Okay, next. It is clear from these values that the speed of light is more in air but less in water and least in glass. First, which has the highest speed of light? Air. Air has a speed of light that is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. After that, water. Water has a speed of light 2.25 × 10⁸ meter per second. And least in glass, speed of light in glass is 2 × 10⁸ meters per second. So, by observing all these values, we conclude that speed of light is more in air but less in water and least in glass. Okay, next. A medium in which the speed of light is more is known as optically rarer medium. So here we are discussing which has a highest in speed of light, air. So a medium in which the speed of light is more is known as optically rarer medium. Air is an optically rarer medium because it has the highest speed of light. So, speed of light in air is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So, air is an optically rarer medium as compared to glass and water. Next, a medium in which the speed of light is less known as optically denser medium, which is the more, when the speed of light is more, then we are calling as it is optically rarer medium. A medium in which the speed of light is less is known as optically denser medium. So glass is an optically denser medium than air and water. Okay, next. Causes of refraction of light. Why it is due to? Now discuss. First one. When a ray of light changes its medium, the basic change that occurs is the change in its wavelength. First, regarding the wavelength, it changes the directions. So when a ray of light changes its medium, the basic change that occurs is the change in its wavelength. This change in the wavelength leads to the change in its velocity, and the change in its velocity responsible for its deviation, and hence refraction takes place. So first, during refraction, wavelength is changing. Whenever the light ray traveling from one medium to another medium, its wavelength changes and its velocity also changes. So due to the change in wavelength and its velocity, it is changing the directions. So hence refraction takes place, bending takes place. Okay, these are the causes of refraction. First one, when a ray of light changes its medium, the basic change that occurs is change in wavelength. First wavelength changes, and then this change in wavelength leads to the change in its velocity. When wavelength changes, its velocity also change. So due to change in velocity, it is deviating. So it is deviating. So its velocity responsible for its deviation, and hence refraction takes place. Okay, next. Terms related to refraction of light. So what are the important terms related to refraction? First one, this is the line interface which separates two medias, and it is x and y. We are taking points, two points. And this is the xy, the section of the plane transparent surface. And here we are drawing the normal. This is the perpendicular line. And next, we are taking a points n1 and n2. Next, we are inserting the light. This blue line indicates the incident ray. And this is a refractor ray. Whenever the light ray travels from one medium to another medium, at an interface is changing the direction. It is bending at and separating two medias. Here it is we are taking a P and a Q and R. PQ is the incident ray, QR is the refracted ray, and it is angle between incident ray and normal is known as angle of incidence, is denoted by letter I. And next, angle of refraction. Angle between normal and refractor ray is known as angle of refraction. It is denoted by letter R. Now, what is meant by transparent surface? The plane surface which refracts light is called a transparent surface. In the diagram, XY is the section of the plane transparent surface. Okay, this is the plane transparent surface. And the next, point of incidence. The point on the transparent surface where the light ray meets it is called a point of incidence. In this diagram, see the diagram carefully. This is the point of intersection. So this point, the point on transparent surface where the light rays meet, is called the point of incidence. So this point is known as the point of incidence. That is, here we are representing the letter Q. Q is the point of incidence. Okay, Q is the point of incidence. Next, we will go to the next point, that is normal. A perpendicular line here we are drawing the perpendicular line, perpendicular drawn on the transparent surface at the point of incidence is called normal. In diagram, N1, Q, N2 is the normal on surface XY. So, this is known as normal. This is the normal. Normal nothing but a perpendicular line or a perpendicular drawn on the transparent surface at the point of incidence is called normal. So, in this diagram, N1, Q, N2 is the normal on the surface XY. Okay, next. Incident ray. The ray of light which strikes the transparent surface at the point of incidence is called incident ray. In this diagram, PQ is the incident ray. Here, PQ is the incident ray. So, this is the incident ray. A ray of light which strikes the transparent surface at this point of incidence is called incident ray. So, in this diagram, which is the incident ray? PQ is the incident ray. Okay. Next. Refracted ray. The ray of light which travels from the point of incidence to into the other medium is called refracted ray. In this diagram, QR is the refracted ray. So, this is a refracted ray. This is refracted ray and this is a incident ray. This is incident ray and this is refracted ray. The ray of light which travels from the point of incidence into another medium is called refracted ray. Okay, next. Angle of incidence. The angle made by the or angle between the incident ray and normal on the transparent surface at the point of incidence is called angle of incidence. It is represented by the symbol I. This is the angle of incidence. Angle between the incident ray, this is incident ray and the normal, normal. This is incident ray and normal on the transparent surface at the point of incidence is called angle of incidence. It is represented by the symbol I. I denotes the angle of incidence. In the diagram, angle PQN1 is the angle of incidence. So, angle of incidence between the angle between the incident ray and the normal is known as angle of incidence. It is denoted by letter I. Next, angle of refraction. Angle of refraction nothing but angle between the refractor ray and the normal on the transparent surface at the point of incidence is called angle of refraction. It is represented by the symbol R. And this is the angle of refraction. It is represented by the symbol small r. This is refractor ray and angle between normal and this is normal. Angle between the refractor ray and the normal on the transparent surface at the point of incidence is called angle of refraction. It is denoted by the symbol R. R denotes the angle of refraction. So, in this figure R, Q, N2 is the angle of refraction. Okay, next. Loss of refraction of light. Here, this is the glass medium and this is glass and it is air. Here we are separating two medias and this is the normal and this is incident ray and this is angle of incidence and this is a point of intersection and it is interface. Interface nothing but a line which separates two medium, and this is refractor ray, and this is normal, and this angle is angle of refraction. Now first law, the incident ray, the refractor ray, and the normal to the surface in the point of incidence all lie in the same plane. Here incident ray and refracted ray and normal, these should be lie in the same plane. Incident ray, refracted ray, and normal at to the surface in the point of incidence all lie in the one plane. Okay, this is the first law of refraction. Next, second law of refraction. For any two given pair of medium, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence of the sine of angle of refraction is constant. The above law is called Snell's law or second law of refraction. Snell's law nothing but the ratio of sine of angle of incidence and sine of angle of refraction, and it is named after the scientist Wilbert Snell's, who first formulated it. So that's why we are calling as Snell's law. Thus sine I by sine R is equals to mu, where mu is refractive index of the second medium with respect to first medium. So this is the second law of refraction. For any given two pair of medium, the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction, here sine of angle of incidence and to the sine of angle of refraction is constant. So this above law is known as the Snell's law. So this law is named after a scientist Wilbert Snellius, who first formulated this. So thus this law is known as Snell's law. Sin I by sin R, I nothing but angle of incidence, R nothing but angle of refraction. So the ratio of sine of angle of incidence and sine of angle of refraction is constant. That constant is known as refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first medium. This is denoted by letter mu. This is a refractive index mu of the second medium with respect to first medium. This is about the second law of refraction. Next, refractive index mu is independent on the angle of incidence, and mu depends on the nature of the medium. So temperature of the medium and wavelength or color of the light. So on what factor refractive index depends? Refractive index depends on the nature of the medium, temperature of the medium, wavelength or color of the medium. So refractive index independent on the angle of incidence. Mu nothing but refractive index, that is constant called refractive index. Mu depends on the nature of the medium, temperature of the medium, wavelength or color of the light. Okay, thanks for watching this video.